Hello friends, welcome to this video on CAT 2019 slot 2 LR question solving. In this video we'll cover two sets. One of these were from set theory and other one was from ordering and sequencing. So let's start with the set which belong to ordering and sequencing. So this is the set we had in the exam. Okay, so I'll read the information and I'll also derive the important pieces of information from the given comprehension. Okay, the first year students in first year are split into six sections. In 2019, business statistics course was taught by six sections by Annie, Betty, Chetan, Dev, Isha, Fakir. So we can use ABCDEF. All sections had common midterm and end term exam with 100 marks each. ET contained more question than MT. Okay, so this is something. Number of questions in ET more than MT, this is important, okay, which we can either, okay, so I've just underlined it, okay. ET contained more questions than, okay, questions from for ET and MT were prepared collectively by six faculties, okay. Considering ET and MT together, six members prepared same number of questions. So what I can say is, first thing is I can write ET is greater than MT, this is, I'm talking about number of questions. And one more thing we can say is ET plus MT, all of them prepared same number of questions. There are six faculties, so we can say this is 6x. ET plus MT number of questions is equal to 6x. Each of ET and MT had at least four questions which were worth five marks. Okay, so I'll just write some information here. Okay, I'll use here 5 marks, 4 plus, then at least 3 questions of 10 marks, so 10 marks, 3 plus and 15 marks, at least 2 questions, okay. So if you see collectively from these, okay, 5 into 4, 20, 10 into 3, 30, 15 into 2, 30. So we can say with this information, we have 9 questions with 80 marks. And then we have another scope of another 20 marks which we can get from any of these values. Okay, now if you can see, the minimum number of additional question has to be 2. Okay, means we can have 15 2 or 10 10. So minimum number of additional question, total number of question minimum can be 11. Okay, maximum can be when we are having 5 marks each. Okay, so 20 marks, we can have 4 such questions. So 9 plus 4, 13 questions. So this is the information we have. Now if you see, ET plus MT is 6x. That means minimum and maximum is, so it can be 11, 13 or 12, 12. But since ET is more than MT, we can derive from here. In ET, we had 13 questions. And in MT, we had 11 questions. In case of 13 questions, we can say 5 marks question will be 4 more, so this will be 8, and here this will be 10, 15 will be 2. Because for having 13 questions, there are 4 additional questions of 5 marks, okay, so we'll add 4 plus 8, okay. 11, we don't know, it can be 5, 15 or 10, 15, so we are just keeping it open till here. Now let's read additional information given. Okay, that in both MT and ET, all 5 marks question preceded 10 mark question and all 15 mark question followed the 10 mark questions. Okay, that means all 5 mark question followed by 10 mark question followed by 15 mark questions. Okay, this is the scene we have. Any prepared 5th question for both MT and ET. Okay, for MT, this question carried 5 marks. So in MT, there were, okay, 5th question means top 5 were 5 marks, okay. That means we had at least 4, so it has to be 5, okay. Now for 11 questions, okay, 9 questions with 4, 3, 2 or 5, 10, 15 marks, okay. We have 2 cases. We can have additional 2 questions of 10 marks or 1 question, or other cases, 1 question of 5 marks and another question of 15 marks. Since we have 5 questions of 5 marks, okay, so this has to be 5, this will remain 3, The additional question will be of 5 and 15, so this will become 3. So this is the sequence we have. Okay. So what we can do is we can write here the number of questions of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So I'll just make a table. We'll write who prepared questions in ET and MT, okay? So I'll write MT here and ET here. Now fifth questions, okay, fifth question, any prepared fifth question for both MT and ET, okay? So we write any here and any here. This was 5 marks, we already know that these are 5 marks here. So we know the sequence, okay, so no need to write here in the table, okay. Any prepared one question for MT, okay, so there's the she prepared only one question, okay, that means others have prepared other question. Every other faculty prepared more than one question for MT, okay. Now if you see, this is 6x, 6x is equal to 24, so each faculty prepared 4 questions. Any has prepared only one questions, okay, question here. So that means in this ET, she has prepared 3 questions, okay, because total 4 questions are necessary, okay. All other faculties have prepared 2 to each, more than any means 2 to each, 2 into 5 plus 1 is 11. And in ET also, everyone prepared 2 questions each, apart except any, she prepared 3 questions, okay. So that is something, so any, so we can write MT and ET. Anyone 3, others 2 each. So this is, we can remember, okay, very important piece of information. All questions prepared by a faculty appeared consecutively in MT as well as ET. That means any is 2 questions will be either 4, 5, 6 or 5, 6, 7 or 3, 4, 5. We don't know, so we're just waiting for other piece of information, pieces of information, okay. Now all questions prepared by a faculty, okay, sorry, point number 4, Chetan prepared 3rd question both in MT and ET. Chetan, okay. Isha prepared 8th question both in ET and MT. So I'll write, I'll just change the Isha here and Isha here. Then Fakir prepared 1st question of MT and the last one in ET. So Fakir is here, there is no one here, okay. Dave prepared last question of MT and first one in ET. Dave. Now what we can do here is, okay, we know that the questions appeared consecutively, okay, point number 3, okay, in MT or ET, so this has to be F because there are 2 questions prepared by Fakir, okay, so. And these have to be C, okay, because these consecutive, okay. Similarly, this has to be D, okay. 8 and 9, they has to be consecutive, okay, because everyone else except any prepared 2 questions each. So this is E. We had A, B is remaining, so I'll write B, B here. So we have sequence for MT, okay. Similarly, we can write D here, C here. Because C, there are 2 questions, they appeared consecutively. Okay, for any, there are 3 questions, so I'll write A, 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 this has to be E, this has to be F, this is remaining, so this has to be B, B. So we have sequence of all the questions in MT as well as ET. We know the number of 5-mark question, 10-mark question, 15-mark question in each of the exams. Now we'll just mark the answers. Second question in ET was prepared by, second question in ET was prepared by Dev. How many 5 marks questions were there in MT and ET combined? 8 plus 5, 30. So answer is option 2, 30. Who prepared 15 marks question for MT and ET? Both, okay. So there are 2 questions, in MT there were 3 questions. And here these are 2 questions, okay. So it's Dave, then Isha and Fakir. Dave, Isha and Fakir. On the Dave, Isha and Fakir, option 4. Which of the following question did Betty prepare in ET? Betty prepare in ET is 10 and 11. So it is 4th, 9th, 10th. So it is 10th question. So answer of this question is option 3. So we had to find importantly this piece of information, this piece of information, and this part. Okay, to finding the find number of questions. Okay, then this question was very easy to solve. Okay, so now let's go to the second question, which is from set theory. Okay, so let's see the next set. So here it is. Okay, we'll read the information first. Okay, students in the college discussing two proposals: A, a proposal by authorities to introduce dress code on campus; B, a proposal by students to allow multinational food franchisees to set up outlets on college campus. A student does not support necessarily either of the two proposals. So when a student can propose means none of the proposals as well. In an upcoming election for students union president, two candidates in fray, Sunita and Ragini. Every student prefer one of the two candidates. That means somebody is preparing Sunita, that person cannot prefer Ragini. Okay, so it's either of these two. A survey was conducted among students by picking a sample of 500 students. Following information was noted from this survey. So if you see from what from the information here, we can see that for Sunita and Ragini, okay, people can support A or B or both. Okay, that is the information we have. Okay. 200 students supported proposal A and 250 students supported proposal B. Okay, among 200 students who supported Sunita as president, union president, 80% supported A. So what I'll do here is, okay, I'll make Venn diagrams. Okay, so this is how we'll have. Okay, so we'll have 1, 2, 3, and 4 areas. Okay, so this will make one for Sunita and one will make for Ragini. Okay, so this is one first Venn diagram. This is the second Venn diagram. Okay. Now, two sets, okay, they will represent A and B, A and B. Let's say this is for Sunita, this is for Ragini. Okay, we'll write total numbers here. Okay, so let's start writing it. Okay, so 200 supported A and 200 supported B. So I'm writing information for Sunita here. Okay, so among students, 200 students who preferred Sunita. So this is 200. As student, 80% has supported A. So among these, 80% supported A means this value is 60. Okay. Now since students are either preferring Sunita or Ragini, okay, 160 supported A means A are supporting Sunita, means remaining 90 should be here. Okay. Among those who prefer Ragini, 30% is supported A. Now, Sunita, support of Sunita is 200, so remaining number 300, they should be supporters of Ragini. Okay, because this is 30% is 90, 30% is, that means this is 300. Okay, so that is what we can find it out. So out of 500, 200 here, 300 here. This number is 30% of 300, which is supporting our information point number 3. 20% of those who supported B preferred Sunita. So 250 cut 20% means 20% of 250 is 50. So I'll write 50 here. Okay. 40% of those who did not support B preferred Ragini. Okay. So who did not support B? Okay. So 250 people did not. So 250 people supported B. 40% of those who did not support it. So number of people who did not support B is 250, yeah. 40% of that is 100. So 100 people, okay, did not support B preferred Ragini. Means except this part, okay, B, other part is 100. So sum of this one as well as this is 100. That means this part B is 300 minus 100, 200. So I will write 200 here. Okay. So 40% is those who did not support B. That means 40% is 250, 100. Okay. That preferred Ragini. Okay. So they should not support the Ragini. Who are not supporting B is 100. So sum of this part as well as this part is 100. That means this part is mutually exclusive. So 300 minus 100 is 200. Every student who preferred Sunita and supported B also supported A. Okay, so that means this part is 0. Every student who preferred Sunita and supported B also preferred. Okay, so only B is 0. That means this is 50. This is 110. That means the remaining part is 40. So we have full information here. Okay. Now, among those who preferred Ragini, 20% did not support any of the proposals. Means out of these 300, 20% did not support any of the proposals. Means this is 60. The outside one is 60. We already know them. Sum of these two is 100. So this means this is 40. This is 50. This is 150. Sum of these is 300. So we have solved this whole thing. Now we are ready to answer the questions. Okay. Among the students who surveyed who supported proposal A, what percentage preferred Sunita for the student union president? Okay. So 250 supporters of A. Out of these supporters, Sunita is 160. So that is 160 divided by 250 is equal to 64%. What percentage of students surveyed did not support proposal A? Preferred Sunita, sorry, Ragini as student president. So not supporter of Ragini is 250. Okay. Out of these, if you see, so those who did, okay, so if you see Ragini's supporter who are not supporting A is 150 plus 60 is 210. If you see who is not supporting A here, these 40. Who is not supporting A here is 60 plus 150, 210. So 210 out of 250 is 84%. What percentage students surveyed who supported both the proposals preferred Sunita as student union president? So this is 50 out of 100. 50 out of 50 plus 50, 100. Which is 50%. So answer of this question is option 2. How many students surveyed supported proposal B? Proposal B did not support A. Supported B but did not support A means this is the part we are talking about. And prefer Ragini as student president, union president, that is 150. So for Ragini, this is 150. For Sunita, it would have been 0. So that is all. Okay. So I would say these two questions were of easy to moderate level. Okay. Once you know that, you have to just apply. The only problem in solving this question would have been understanding those statements. Okay. And writing in the Venn diagram. Apart from that, solving and everything was pretty easy. So that is all from this video. Thank you very much.